This is going to be the first video in a series on diabesity. I'm not sure if you look that up in the dictionary, whether you're actually going to find that as a word, but I think we all get the connection. Let's talk about this for a few minutes. First of all, the staggering costs of diabetes in America. There are 30 million Americans with diabetes. This is according to the CDC, and they say 86 million with prediabetes. If you've seen other videos on our channel, you know that that estimate is very conservative. It's based only on fasting glucose numbers as well as hemoglobin A1C. You can miss. It's hard to tell right now because there's not a lot of studies that draw this linkage. But in my experience, an estimate, if you add an insulin survey or OGTT to those two tests, you get probably at least 30, maybe 50% more people actually have prediabetes than the CDC is estimating here. Bottom line is, we have no clue how many people actually have prediabetes. People say that the diabetes and prediabetes epidemic is driven by the obesity epidemic. And I would say, and there's two different sides to that point. The first one is aging is actually a more powerful driver of prediabetes and diabetes. The second thing I'd say, though, is that aging and obesity, or obesity goes along, tends to go along with aging. You talk about that, quote, middle-aged spread. So in one day, there'll be over almost 4,000 people diagnosed with diabetes. The cost is estimated to be $322 billion per year. One in three Medicare dollars is spent on people with diabetes. And again, this is not talking about cardiovascular issues, heart attack, stroke risk for people with prediabetes. This is one in $3 being spent on people with full-blown diabetes. And one in five healthcare dollars overall being spent on people with diabetes. So again, there's a lot of diabetes and it's having a huge impact on us as a nation. It's having a huge impact on the rest of the world too. Thank you for your interest. My name is Ford Brewer. I started off my career as an ER doc, and that can be frustrating because most of the things bringing patients into the ER can and should be prevented, like heart attack and stroke. So I went to Johns Hopkins for training in prevention, did well, ended up running the program, trained dozens of docs there, and have trained hundreds and even over 1,000 doctors since then in preventing disease. What's even more important is I've helped thousands of patients prevent heart attack and stroke rather than waiting for the devastation and hoping for a cure.